So I want to try to make sure that when I come, you know, back later tomorrow, that this stuff is gone.
Like so many of his neighbors, David Broadbridge piles smelly, soggy, flood-soaked debris on the roadside in front of his house. The debris trucks are rolling, and he just wants it out of here. But if it's not properly separated, it could wind up sitting right where it is.
We had to cut the sheetrock out, so that's what we have right here to the right of me. Then, of course, you got all your junk that got wet, and that could be anywhere from throw blankets to things like that. Guess I'll leave that in. Things like that. And then if you have some old cans, I see my neighbor has some cans of paint over there. You have to separate those.
It's important for people to understand, if we are to utilize the federal funding that's available to this parish, then we need to play by their rules, which means we have to separate those.
All of the debris does not go to a single landfill. White goods, appliances like washing machines and dishwashers go one place, while wet sheetrock and other construction debris go someplace else. And not everything will be picked up by the trucks in a single pass.
All right.
Just because the truck's been through once doesn't mean everything's going to be gone.
That's correct.
Okay.
Because they go to different landfills.
I know a lot of my neighbors today were going out about separating it because a lot of them had it in bags. If it's in bags, they won't pick it up.
And that is true. It's one of three pretty important things to remember. First, get the debris to the curb or roadside so that the trucks can actually reach it. Also, make sure to separate construction debris from those appliances and from household hazardous waste. And that's right, don't put it in those black garbage bags.
The debris hauler can't see what's inside. It could be a bag of teddy bears or it could be a bag of household hazardous waste.
So again, separate the debris, don't put it in bags, and get it close enough to the street because crews cannot come on private property to pick up the debris. In St. Tammany, Heath Allen, WDSU News.